Hey, what's up? Long time no video. Apologies for that. I didn't plan to have a 2-year break in uploading my next video for YouTube. Reason that's been the case is I've had personal issues going on, job related issues. I've changed jobs a couple times. I've moved. I used to be in Kawasaki, now I'm in Tokyo. So that will help with the logistics of making more videos because I'll be closer to places I want to go check out. And also will give me more material to kind of introduce some of the nooks and crannies of Tokyo that you may not get to see from other videos or from a tour guide book or etc. etc. So I just want to give an update what I'm doing and what's been going on, and also to kind of get in to back into making new videos. I'm going to go ahead and combine this update with another video I've been meaning to do for a while, but we'll get to that in a second. Part of the reason I've kind of gotten off my ass to try to make this video is because this coming weekend, which will be tomorrow, there will be the Japan/Tokyo area YouTube gathering. We are all going to be getting together in Shibuya, and I'm looking forward to being able to meet some of the guys I've been checking out for quite a long time and get to see them face to face. I don't have many subscribers compared to a lot of these guys, but still, it'll be kind of cool to hang out with the cool kids of the Japan YouTube channels and see what they're like in real life. Couple things. I want to give a shout out to my bud Tikyo Sam. I know he'll be there tomorrow. We've gone out and done a few things, had a few beers here and there, helped him move his TV, so he's a really good guy. I know a lot of people like to hate on him because of his kind of bombastic personality, but he's a good guy. Kind of what you see is what you get, and he's fun to be around. So little message to the haters there that want to give him crap. Another person I want to give a shout out to is A Sound Like Silence. Hope I said that right. Got my little notes here. Yeah, he sent me a private message a long time ago. Sorry I didn't get back to you, dude. Like I said, shit happens. Just been doing stuff. Still looking for work. That's been a big issue. Still having to deal with that. So that's the main reason I didn't get back to you. But I like your message. Thanks. Unfortunately, I don't have any cool nunchakun to swing around, but moving into the other video I wanted to make for a long time, I do have this. So you might appreciate getting a good close-up look at this. This is my sword. It is a real deal. So I'll let you see some of the detail of the kashira, if it'll focus. The manuki, which I thought was really cool. It's got a little dragon style there. And now you're hearing the local garbage ladies that are in the background. You're probably picking up on the audio. Here's my fuchi. You can see more so on this side. Hope it focuses. Focus, focus, focus. That's the mask, I don't know the name of that, for the samurai armor on there. And then looking at the tsuba, it's like a looks like a grapevine pattern to me. In gold inlay. So hard to get it. Try to get so you can see there. Also, the fuchi has a gold inlay on it. I don't know if it's real gold, but it looks close enough for government work. And that's not going to focus, is it? There we go. Let's see, that's a samurai in armor on my kashira there. So, there we go. Autofocus is screwing up. Anyway. And here's the silk sageo, nice Barney the Dinosaur purple. Let's check out the blade. As I said, this is my cutter, so you can see in the Mono Uchi, I've got the polish has kind of gotten jacked up a bit because I do use it for cutting. But you can see the original Hamon is a little much nicer here. It hasn't been basically polished off from using it as a cutter so much. That's basically what happens is the in the Mono Uchi, it basically kind of gets almost a mirror finish, but you can still see the Hamon a bit. It's just kind of darkened from using it so many times to cut, and then the water. I do have some rust on it. You may be able to see a few spots there. Shame on me. And since it's a high carbon blade, instead of being the red, rusty iron color, it's dark. When it does get rust on it, it's dark black, basically because of the high carbon content on the blade. So, let's go ahead and flip so you can see the other side. Again, now this is, we're getting into the Mono Uchi. Yeah, it's kind of, the Hamon kind of disappears. It's what they say in Japanese, shogunai, it can't be helped. You can use your sword or you can have it be pretty. You can't do both. So, if you want to cut with it, this is going to happen. It's just the nature of being a high carbon steel blade. I don't know if the camera's picking it up, but like I said, it kind of is in through here. It's gotten dark stains on the blade. And you really can't do much about it. Even if you wipe it off immediately after cutting, it's going to do that. So, my very first cut, I looked at it, I was like, ah! But I didn't buy it to be a safe queen. I bought it to use it to cut with. And there's more detail of a few rust spots it's gotten on there. But I bought it to be used, so nothing more to be done about it. And anyway, hope you like that, getting a close-up of my blade. According to the shop that I bought it from, it's either about a 300-year-old blade, or more likely, it's maybe only about 90, 100 years old. So, looking at the shape of the blade and the pattern of the steel, it's probably not that old. It's probably only about 100 years old. I had a couple different friends of mine that I train in Yaido with. They have done a lot more research, know a lot more about swords than I do. They told me it's probably only about 100 years old, which makes me feel a lot less guilty for screwing up the polish. But the person I bought it from, they can easily get that back into showroom quality condition if I am willing to fork out the cash and to part with it for up to 6 months, maybe a year, however long it takes to get it done. So anyway, I'm going to try to roll in some more better still pictures that I took right after I bought the blades. That way you can see the original condition of the Hamon, and hopefully you'll enjoy the sword porn that I roll in. Again, apologies that it's been so long since I've updated and posted a video, and apologize to you, Sound Silence, for not getting back to you earlier. Again, thanks for the comment, thanks for the message you sent me. So, hope you enjoy this vid, and I fully intend to get off my ass and put more videos out. So, look forward to seeing you for the next one. Alright, take care.